Are you a Trello user and would you like to learn how to use time boxing in Trello? Well, this week that's what I want to do in my time boxing series. I don't really have a name for this, but anyway, time boxing is a system or method that I currently use in Todoist. And what I wanted to do is I want to use this series, I want to show you how you can set up time boxing in different types of applications. So last week we did a very minimalist application called To-Do. I've also obviously covered this in Apple Reminders, and I've covered this in my very own Todoist. But this week I want to show you how you can set up time boxing with a Kanban style to-do list manager, and I've decided I'm doing this in Trello. But you could do this quite easily in Asana as well. It's just that Trello, I actually have the application on my computer. I should point out I don't use it, I just use it for demo purposes. So without further ado, I would just like to ask you, if you do get any value from this and you would like to help me, then please hit that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you would like to get all the tips, tricks and news on productivity and productivity systems, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me now take you into Trello and show you how you can set up time boxing and use it for yourself. Okay, so here is the Trello board set up with the time boxes. Now remember, you can do this with Asana if you wish. I'm just choosing Trello, but Asana would work in exactly the same way. So essentially along the top, I've got my long term. These are for tasks or even projects if you wish, that need to come up in the next 3 to 6 months, for example. Then we have next month, we got this month, next week, and this week. Now this month is going to be very quiet because we're right at the very end of February at the time of recording. So of course I don't have very much in there. When it comes to the end of the month, i.e. will be this weekend, what I would do is I would transfer the items in this column over to this column. And then I would look at the items I have in my long term to see if there's anything in here that needs to be done. So for example, this one here, April, would be next month from next week. So that would be dragged across. And maybe I want to organize my holiday to Jamaica. So again, I could drag that one across. Of course, I got this week in here, next week here, which normally in my own Todoist is generally toward the end of the week is going to be a lot bigger than that. But this is just a sample. And then, of course, I've got this week right here. So one of the benefits of using Trello or Asana, but Trello in particular, is you can create checklists within a card. So, for example, I would have, if I was using Trello, I would actually have a floating shopping list. And what I mean by that is this task here can be moved, it can be dragged about. I would keep it in my this week. I wouldn't necessarily check this one off. And what I would have inside there is the checklist that I've got. So I've got the grocery checklist here, which is apples, almonds, Greek yogurt, blueberries, broccoli, bananas, etc. So these are all here. So I can just add things to that as and when I need to add them. And you can do this like for record videos for next week. One of the things I would do if I was using this particular setup is I would actually have a checklist, which Trello does give you. You can just add a checklist here, and you can add multiple checklists within each card. So I would actually add the checklist here. So I've got the Todoist video, this Trello video, my Productivity Mastery Series video, and I need to do some new images for my profile. So that just all goes in there. These are the things that I can do for when I'm doing my audio visual time, which would be on Friday afternoon. So I could actually, I've put a date there for the 28th, which would be the Friday. So that's all in there. And essentially, that's how I would set up Trello. Now, Trello is beautiful because you can actually add the images. I can't do that in To-Do. I could do it in Apple Reminders, and I can add images to my Todoist, but it doesn't show the images as well as obviously Trello does, because like reviewing maps for Crab Creek, I've got the actual map here for Crab Creek, which is right there, and I can go in and I can see it always in a lot bigger detail right there if I needed to. So this is a really good way of using for time boxes, and actually it probably lends itself a lot more naturally to this kind of things that you would do. So these are the sort of things that you can do with Trello. You can add these up. Now, of course, if this was my real account, this is going to be a lot bigger. But on a mobile phone, I think it actually works a lot better because you can actually set it up so that you can see this week. And just by swiping between your different boards, you can add tasks and whatever you want to do. So on the mobile device, this is really very quite effective. So there you go. This is what I wanted to do. I wanted just to show you how you could set up the time boxes in a Kanban board type app like Trello or Asana. As I say, Asana would work brilliantly. If you don't like the green background, you can actually add all sorts of different backgrounds. You can change the background here. So if I wanted to, I could change it to blue. I can change it to pink, red. I can change this to whatever color I want. I can even have images, and I'm using the free account here with Trello. I'm not using the paid account, so I can actually have this in the background, which doesn't do change very much. Oh, it does give me a little bit of a background. I can do this, so you can change your background and have whatever you want as your background for Trello, which is actually kind of one of those unique features in Trello, though Wunderlist did do this also. So there are a few options that you have right there. But essentially, that's how it would always set up on Trello. And I think it's a really good system for time boxing. But once again, I should reiterate, I have no plans of changing my system from Todoist. I love Todoist. I've been using it for many years now. I totally understand it. I'm only just brushing the surface here with Trello to show you what you can do if you really wish to set up the time boxes. So hopefully you've got some ideas. So for you Trello users out there, here you go. This is how I would set up the time boxing system in Trello. Just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you very much for watching this video. Now I have a question for you. Are you ready to go beyond the to-do list? Now, the reason I ask that question is because your to-do list is never going to do the work for you. Your to-do list is only ever going to show you what needs to be done. And that often can cause a lot of anxiety, a lot of stress, and a lot of overwhelm. What really helps you to get your work done and what really helps you to become much more productive is developing your own workflow. A workflow that you work from every single day that makes sure that you stay focused on the things that you have identified are the most important things to you. Now that could be your work, it could be your goals, it could be your family, it could be your personal life, it could be your self-development. Whatever that is entirely personal to you. But the key is to develop the workflow so that you are consistently making small steps towards achieving the things that you want to achieve every single day. And that's why I have developed my Productivity Mastermind course, Creating Your Very Own Custom Workflow. And I would love for you to check out the course. The course is available now, details of which are in the notes below, and I would just love to see you in this course. So please join me in the Productivity Mastermind course, Developing Your Very Own Custom Workflow, because this is a course that's going to take you way beyond the to-do list so that you start to really move forward on the goals and the things that you have identified are important to you. Thank you very much.